Hey there, how have you all been? Trust you and your families are safe and at home. In today's video, we are going to cover a very important question that have been asked so many times. That is, which certificates do you need to crack any data science interview, right? So, firstly, I would officially like to welcome you all to the Data Monk. Just a brief introduction, we at Data Monk have created number of playlists for you to cover each and everything you might need to crack your dream job. We have left no stone unturned and have put all our heart and efforts into creating videos, articles, quizzes, case studies, guess estimates, and even ebooks for you. We have tried covering each and everything and providing you all the resources that are available to crack your data science interview. You can check all of them, if not yet, at www.thedatamonk.com. Alright. So in today's video, we are not going to cover SQL or pandas or K nearest neighbors for that matter, but an equally important topic which we all need to understand before creating our resumes and sitting in for any interviews. So we have got a lot of queries asking what all certifications should I do to crack the interview, how many certificates are enough, which certificates have higher value, should I enroll myself into paid certificates, and the list goes on. We have got all the answers covered for you, and that is, yes, you guessed it right. The answer to all these questions is none. You don't need any certificate to prove if you are perfect fit for the job or not. There's no certificate that guarantee you'll land the job that you want. Alright? So, trust me, none of the recruiters may be like, maybe like 1% they consider that how many certificates you hold. I'm not trying to demotivate you. I know completing certificates require consistency, efforts, and a lot of hard work. And definitely they are resources, great resources for learning and knowledge, but not to crack your data science interviews. For a technical and practical field like data science, where you're crunching with numbers every day and you're basically determining the future, you're holding a lot of power in your hands. And this power comes from practical implementations, projects, actual deployment of data, and not from certificates, trust me. Until and unless you use your knowledge into implementing data and analytical thinking, certificates are of no use. Rather, you should treat your certifications as the beginning of your journey. After completing the tutorials, you know you have the knowledge now. Now it's time to use that knowledge into working on live data sets, contributing to open sources, helping your friends or other people with problems they are stuck onto. That's where you learn, and that's what the company needs whenever they are recruiting data scientist, right? So what matters is your experience. Work on as many live data sets as you can before calling yourself, I am, say, this and this certified. Then that certificate is definitely a big achievement. Experience combined with certificates is what you need to crack your job. We at Data Science, at Data Monk, believe the same. And if you check our videos, after covering basics, we are focusing on what kind of questions have been asked in interviews, how you can crack them. We have videos on case studies and guess estimates that have been asked in interviews, that have been asked in actual interviews like Zomato or, OYO, all of these interviews. We have been in touch with a lot of people who have cracked these data science interviews. So we are basically speaking with experience. And we are trying to present the same experience to you through our videos. We see, in today's data science curriculum at colleges or the courses that are being offered online, it's all theory. and none of it is going to give you the exposure that you actually need. So what you actually need is a real world experience, and we believe in the same. Because in real world, you will be facing new challenges every day. You will be learning new things every day, which you wouldn't even have heard in many of the certifications. So this is why real-time experience is so important. And when you work on your own project, when you, you know, start your project and you work on it from the beginning to the end, you not only learn the core concepts of the subject, but so many other things, like, you know, patience, say, dealing with the bugs that you get, then how to strike when you are stuck between, you know, data pre-processing or whatever stage you are on to, and completing your work within deadlines, and so much more. You learn so much more when you are into the real world experience. So all we are saying is, why to make mistakes when you can learn from people with experiences? And for that, we have collated all these experiences into our videos, articles, ebooks, and the best part is you don't have to pay for these experiences. So we are not trying to demotivate or say that certificates are of no use and you shouldn't pursue any certificate, and you know, there's no point doing any certifications. Certifications can be very, very, very helpful. They can be helpful in pointing you into the right direction. But with the right kind of experience. These certificates could be of great use, but with the right kind of experience. We hope you crack your dream job, and we would like to contribute as much as we can into your data science journey. So keep learning, keep crunching the numbers, and don't run after certificates. Let them come to you with experience. So I hope I was able to answer all the questions that were asked in the very beginning of the videos. What certificates, with certificates, how many certificates and all. So it's just upon you. Certificate is a piece of paper. If you want to bring it to life, you need to do that with your experience, with your projects, with your real life experiences. So keep learning, keep crunching the numbers. And that's it for the video. See you in the upcoming ones. All the very best.